Hello designers, learn how to create a flat design using Illustrator by following this easy tutorial. You can start by downloading the sketch file from the description of this video that we use as our reference and trace. Open up Illustrator and create a new document, drag the sketch on the canvas, then go to the transparency tab and lower it to 20%. From the layers panel, you'd want to lock it up and create a new one where we'll have the shapes of this character. Remove the color applied to the outline, and because we're starting with the face, let's choose a contrasting color. Double click on the fill and choose a light green, which will be used for the arms as well. We'll need to create an oval, so make sure to pick the ellipse tool and click and drag from the center while holding down the Alt key to create the shape. Switch to the pen tool and trace the neck area. You don't need to make it perfectly symmetrical, only make sure it overlaps with the face. Because I want to see the sketch, I'll move the shapes below and move forward with the hands. Using the pen tool, I'll try to create arms that are bended a bit. Keep in mind that whenever you want to start with a straight path, click on the anchor once you've defined the bezier curve like this and close this shape. While holding down the Alt key, I'll drag a copy to the other side and make sure we're ready to work on the dress. And just to get some separation from the background, I would recommend choosing a light gray color, and with the pen tool, start from the left hand, go across it and create a big curve on top of the neck, then close the shape down from the other side. For the midsection, start from the line in the sketch and keep in mind that the hand will be masked by the hips. As you probably noticed, you can definitely go out of bounds and make small adjustments along the way to create something more unique. As this hand will actually go on top, just make sure that there are no empty spots left and use existing anchors to place new ones on top. With the hand selected, right click and bring it to the front of the illustration. Before we move any further, let's make sure that the neck is visible, so send this shape behind it by using a quick shortcut. The color of the hair needs to be darker, so start exploring with different shapes in the color picker. The first shape is going to be one at the top, which will look like hair split in two sides, and using the pen tool you can start defining the paths that make up this shape. Afterwards, create a new shape that will go behind everything. Because I would like to have consistent corners, I'll start with drawing straight paths, send it behind everything, and with the direct selection tool, start by selecting the first two anchors on the sides and drag on the circle that shows up to round them up. Do the same thing for the bottom ones and hide the sketch layer to take a look over what we've created so far. There still needs to be a background created and add the final details of this flat illustration. Define a rectangle that has the same light gray color as the dress and send it behind everything, and with the direct selection tool give the impression that the character is looking in a different direction, and of course add a small ear on the other side for more personality. Because the face and neck are blending, select the curvature tool and create a stroke outline that's using the color of the hair to define some separation. Increase the stroke size till it covers the gaps left from the face, and from the stroke panel select around a joint and a cap. Do the same thing for the body, and this is the final look of the flat design character. Thank you for watching till the end, and don't forget to like this video so more people could see it, and subscribe for more design tutorials. Don't hesitate to let me know if you have any questions in the comments section, and enjoy the rest of your day. Take care, everybody. Bye!